As the Mac has moved to the Catalina OS and to 64-bit processing, you'll find that some of the earlier 32-bit file formats for video will no longer be recognized and hence will not be able to be used in Final Cut. In this video, I'll show you how to use VLC, which is another one of those free applications that support Final Cut, and I'll show you how that will convert these 32-bit files so that Final Cut can read them. I'm Bruce McBride, and my goal is to improve your knowledge and to speed up your workflow in Final Cut. Below you will find descriptions and links, and also the timestamps for this video. If you haven't already, please like, subscribe, and press the bell. To get some background on 64-bit processing and the incompatible file formats, I suggest you have a look at Apple's website. They have a page specifically on this, and the link is in the description below. VLC will read most image format and will convert these files into a format that can be used by Final Cut Pro. You'll find that the AVI format is one of the most common that you will encounter. So let's look at an AVI file and see how we can work with that in Final Cut. So I have an AVI, which is the spinning globe. If I drag that now into the Final Cut application, you'll see that it says it's not a compatible file. So as it stands, we can't use it. What we need to do, though, is to go to that image, the world globe, and we'll take it down and we'll put it on top of VLC. So VLC has read that file and it's showing us the globe spinning. If we want to convert that now, then we will need to come to the file menu and select convert. We'll need to drag that globe file on top of the drop media location. So let's find it in the finder and drag it in there, world globe, and then we can decide what format we want to convert that to. MP4, that's 264, is the best choice in this case. And we can then decide where we want to store it. So we'll call that globe, and now we'll save it. And there it is there as an MP4 file. So we can simply drag that into Final Cut. And if we look here, we can see the image there in the browser. We can now simply drag that into the timeline. And then when we play through, there's the converted AVI file playing in Final Cut.
I hope this video has shown you the need to be able to convert file formats so that Final Cut can now read them. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching.